Welcome to the webcast on using domain-specific modeling languages for application development in industrial control systems like PLC software. I have here a case of a heating system. So domain-specific languages for heating systems. First, we describe a system by using these high-level domain concepts of a heating system. Then we generate the code, PLC code, which we have then underlying platform, a Beckhoff PLC environment, TwinCat, and then we can basically run it. So let's inspect these models and generate code in a little bit more detail. I have here Metadata Plus for modeling my heating systems. So I have here two domain-specific languages, one for describing the platform, what kind of pipes and instruments I have and how they are connected. So basically here in the toolbar, I don't use PLC or IEC 61.31 concepts, but the domain concepts like valves, radiators, pumps, and so forth. So now we also have here rules of the system here in this language. So here you can see some of the checkings, like the pump doesn't have any outgoing pipe, and therefore we can update the model and make a connection from the pipe, from the pump to the thermostat and to the valve. And we can give also some length values here. And now the warnings have disappeared, and we can also add just, for example, the cover. So we could say that this is a thermally insulated cover, and now also the visual appearance to the diagram is shown which pipes are covered and which aren't. This describes now the structure of the system. If you look, for instance, the pump behavior, so you here can see a state machine describing how the pumps are controlled. So the system is initialized, then we go to the control pump. If flame is detected, we put the pump on. We could also add here another condition with a trade transition that if flame is not detected, so here you can see it again, domain concepts, what kind of things we ask from a burner, and if flame is not detected, then we should put the pump off. So here you can see again domain concepts, what kind of things we can do with the pump on and off. In a similar manner, there are also other kind of models for describing, for example, the burner state machine, which is more complex, like how the valves are open and off, and also conditions to combine that if boiler requires to be warmed up or radiator air one requires to be warm up, then we go to the control burner state. And if there is the negation that not either of them is needed, then we go to the wait for request. There are also similar kind of things for radiators, like if a thermostat room temperature is smaller or equals to the set temperature, then we ask radiator to be warmed up. So this basically describes now the heating system and its logic by using heating concepts directly. Not programming concept, but the higher level domain concept is the rules. We also have checkings here with the models of different kind. So you saw this pump earlier. If I want to add here, for example, another kind of a pump and would like to control the venturi pump P2, then I have also checking here. Not only that pump P2 doesn't have connections, but I can also see here that this system doesn't have any existence of a pump P2, so I can't even control it. The next thing is that we can actually generate here the code and run this. I'm also now here using existing platform, so there's existing legacy code providing the primitives for heating systems. So here you can see the basic base blocks available in a conventional manner, manually written here, like the burner, my burner framework, my pump, and the pump services, putting on and off and so forth. But these are just the primitives, no logic, nothing to relate to our particle system like illustrated here. So the next, what we'd like to do is we would like to run this system. So I'm now generating the code, calling the TwinCat PLC control. Here you can see the generated code. And now it's also included and imported here into this project, home heating platform project. So it has the base blocks, but also have now the generated code from the models. So here you can see the different states and individual state machine implementations, like for instance the pump over here. So this piece of code was generated from the model that you saw earlier for putting pump on and off. No errors, code is correct, but there are some warnings because we also need to allocate them into a system manager so we can say basically how the generated code is then executing the simulation. So we are actually also generating here the simulation part. So we can actually now run and show it here in this 32-bit Windows 8 machine. So the next thing I need to do the mappings between the different kind of variables that I have, inputs and outputs in my generated code, to the inputs and outputs that I have in a simulation system, which we are soon going to be run. So for example, here we could pick the flow sensor and maps it value to the output value in the simulation or input value in the simulation. And basically we need to do this for inputs and outputs, but they go into both ways. So we only need to add use the inputs like these couple of two mores, and then we can generate the mappings. So now we have a mapping generated to the system. So if we compile it again or build it again, now we don't have any warnings either. So the next thing is we can do is we can run it. But let's put first this system running. Let's start it. I'm using here the TwinCat from Beckhoff. Okay, privileges. Yes. So now we have the system running, and I can see here the other kind of code, data types, resources being generated, the mappings, and here is also the visualization. And now we can log into the system, and the system should be starting. We run it, and now if you go to the system, we can basically see that it starts to work because the room temperature decreases. Or let's say I put the hot water running, so the temperature of the water in the boiler decreases because the cold water is coming to replace it, and when it reaches the cold enough, the burner goes on, the pump goes on, and the valve heats the boiler. But if I put more room temperature, now also both the room and boiler is heated. But if I close the hot water tap, now the temperature starts to increase in the boiler. And when it reaches the 90 degrees, then it should stop the boiler and the burner, like this. Now the pump and boiler went again because the room temperature decreased. So basically the logic to the generated code came all from these high-level domain-specific models. Like for instance, if the room temperature was smaller than the required temperature, we want to put the boiler warming on. But we don't need to think this in terms of the program code. We can think and design the solution by using domain-specific high-level concepts. So you don't need to at all see the code because it's generated from the models to the animation to the system to be executed. Thank you for watching this video on generating PLC code from domain-specific models.